Well, the world has taken a strange turn, hasn't it? COVID has introduced a number of changes to the way that we work and play. Cloner Mingette produced this video to explain the steps KRA is taking to try and keep everyone as safe as possible, all while realizing that we really don't understand much about COVID. As we learn more, please expect changes to our policies and procedures. Thanks in advance for helping us. So what do we know about COVID? The short answer is not much. The medical experts know that it can make you very sick and even perhaps kill you. As the scientists learn more, there may be more changes to how we play ringette. Don't be surprised if the policies and procedures change without a lot of notice. Some general procedures that do seem to help in preventing the spread. First, keep your physical distancing to more than 6 feet or 2 meters. Next, wash your hands frequently. Third, don't come to practice or games when you're not feeling well. So watch for changes to the way that you enter and exit arenas. There should be a one-way flow to increase that physical distancing. As well, there will be check-in questionnaires for each player that will arrive before each game and practice. Please fill them out. If you're not a player and you're entering the building, there will be a safety check-in station. You will be asked a couple of quick questions and your contact details will be recorded. This encourages everyone to be healthy when they come to play, and it helps with contact tracing if there is a COVID exposure within KRA. So what will change? KRA will send out free emails with any changes as soon as we have information from BC Ringette. Please watch for these emails. Currently, there are restrictions on the number of people in a building, the way people flow through the building, and of course, wearing of masks. Depending upon the rink your team is playing in, there might be different rules. Each facility can make their own additional rules on top of those of the provincial health order. Everything from gameplay to tournaments will change for the foreseeable future. Your patience and understanding are definitely appreciated. So as a quick overview, here are some details around the different progressions mandated by BC Ringette. Let's take a quick look. So if we're in progression one, these are some of the changes that you can expect. Progression one is the tightest progression, and we are extremely limited to what we can do. There's no contact between players, so this means skills and drills on practice ice only. There are no games, no spectators or unnecessary people in the building, and physical distancing means that you have to keep at least 6 feet or 2 meters between players and any other people who happen to be around you. Players should come fully dressed as there will be limited time to change into skates only. Visiting in groups, whether it's parents or spectators inside or outside of the building, is highly discouraged. Everyone has to mask up, except when directly on the ice. So these policies apply to the U12 team and older. Fun and U10 won't be on the ice quite yet. Moving to progression two will allow for the U10s and younger age groups to play as long as they can skate. If your player cannot skate on their own yet, then they are asked not to be on the ice quite yet. The physical distancing rules prevent coaches and other on-ice help from getting close enough to pick up a player if they fall down on the ice, if they can't skate. Progression three allows for some loosening of these policies. Changes you can expect here are teams can be formed and closer play can happen on the ice between players within the same cohort. Cohorts will be formed to limit the exposure between people and to make contact tracing easier in case of a COVID exposure. And a cohort is just a group of people that you will always hang out with. Players should still come dressed for play as there will again be limited dressing room access. Distancing on the ice is recommended if possible, but there can be some 3-on-3 gameplay, perhaps some 5-on-5, depending upon the age group. Facility policies might be a little bit more flexible. Some arenas may allow a limited number of spectators, and yet some may not. Some gameplay is allowed, although it will be very limited and to local gameplay only. Masks are mandatory for some arenas and recommended for others. Still no tournaments, so please check with your coach to see which policies apply to the arena that you're playing in. progression 4 is what we're all hoping for. This is a return to normal play with no changes to any of the policies or procedures whatsoever. Hopefully our season goes well and COVID makes a rapid exit. In the meantime, be prepared for the unexpected, be flexible, and be patient while we all adjust to the new normal. If you'd like more details into what, where, when, why, and how of the KRA COVID safety plan, please check out our other COVID video under the resources section on the KRA website. Stay safe. Stay safe and enjoy your season.